Hi class, and welcome to my digital narrative. In order to answer the question, what social factors made me want to be a teacher, I'm going to start where life started for me, in Charleston, West Virginia, and take you through some events and decisions that brought me to present-day Orlando. First, I'll start out by talking about my upbringing. I was born and raised in small town Charleston, where my family owned their own business and were considered middle class when it comes to socioeconomic status. From a very young age, my sister and I were immersed in this business because our childhood home was actually the model home for my parents' company. Therefore, we were involved in a lot of day-to-day operations and saw good things and some bad things. From this experience later on in life, I realized that I knew I wanted a career with stability, but I also witnessed my parents' dedication and drive to succeed, and I believe that that was instilled in me also. Next, I want to talk about my kindergarten and first grade teacher, Mrs. Keener. Now, I didn't always want to be in education, but the moment I applied to the TESOL program, I reached out to her. And this really shows what an impact she's had throughout my life. She's stuck with me literally and figuratively. Whenever we were younger, she would attend our dance recitals, soccer games, birthday parties, all the way up to high school graduation. And we even text or call one another when big events happen in our lives today. She even sends me a greeting card for every holiday. Another role that pushed me into having this open-mindedness and this drive was the role that soccer played in my life. I started playing at the age of 4 and played up through college when I was 22, and this social sub-community allowed me to build most of my relationships, confidence, leadership skills, and competitiveness. There was, however, like in the community that I mentioned before, a fight to be recognized as a positive and competitive woman soccer player. I was out there with the boys and not necessarily getting the same accolades. And this really opened my eyes to gender roles that were present in our community when I was in high school and college. And I decided, maybe subconsciously at the time, that I wanted to do something about it. So in college, I majored in public relations and writing, and I decided to try to pursue a career where I could be heard and I could help others be heard. And from my past experiences in soccer, that career pursuance came in writing for professional women's soccer. Now, this journey took me out of small town West Virginia and landed me right in the heart of Miami, writing for an unpaid internship. To say the least, this move turned my life upside down socioeconomically, culturally, and definitely linguistically. To give a little insight, I did have trouble finding a job right out of college. And this was a really big hit to my confidence because I was trying to live the American dream where I left home and I'm gonna go make a career in a big city that is totally opposite from the environment that I grew up in. Well, unbeknownst to me, the language barrier hit me pretty hard. I didn't speak Spanish, I didn't speak Portuguese, and I had never really encountered many different cultures other than that I grew up with. So eventually I was able to get a job at Apple, and the language barrier still was an issue, but I was provided resources there with my coworkers or the use of technology to get through transactions. The experience that I felt in Miami, this blow to my confidence, this blow to my socioeconomic status, really motivated me to not want anyone else to have to go through that. And I started talking to some friends about the TESOL-TEFL field and realized that I definitely had passions to lie there. And if I could make an impact, once again, that's what I wanted to do. This is when I applied to UCF. I had my first teaching experience. Paula is a customer that I met at the Apple store, and we connected on the fact that she has been teaching English as a foreign language for 20 years.
Introduce herself, and she's gonna say some words about her life, and what she.
Okay. When I met Paula in the Apple store over the summer and talking, and why do you need this computer? Oh, I teach English online. Oh my gosh, that's what I want to do. So
then this experience allowed me to build the confidence to apply for an immersion experience in the Dominican Republic. I've talked about this experience in class multiple times, but the background on the players is they were New York Mets baseball recruits, and they aged all male, and they ranged in age from 15 to 30 years old. It was a very interesting situation because they were being forced to take English. It was not something that they necessarily wanted to do for their own. And so that factor definitely played into the classroom. I saw that they were unmotivated and even tried to develop very customized lessons based on things that they were going to deal with when they got to the U.S., how to do a media interview, how to rent an apartment, how to deal with U.S. money, how to order at a restaurant. And I've found that this is a huge challenge for me as a teacher, but it was also a way for me to grow. Overall, I wasn't necessarily respected as a woman in this role. It was a 3-month struggle, but I did learn a lot. Do not regret going at all. And overall, it helped me shape my identity as a teacher, and I know that I'm proud to be a woman in education that left her home, changed her lifestyle multiple times, went through ups and downs socioeconomically. I can deal with different cultures, I can deal with different languages, and I can thrive in environments where I feel like I can make a personal impact on one of my students. So that is my teaching identity and where I see myself now and where I hope to be heading down the path in the future. Thank you.